your hand out, demanding that I pay the money that I work for. At least that's what you say. But what gives you that power? Who died and made you boss? I'm barely getting by today. I can't afford that loss. So if you don't show some legal obligation that I pay, put your hand back in your pocket.
Well, hello there. I'm Hartwell Broussard, and I welcome you to HELP, the program with help and a request for help. The reason help is needed is because America is in distress. If you notice in the background, the American flag is displayed upside down. When a flag is displayed upside down, it is done so as a distress signal. If you wish to confirm that, go to the United States Code, Title 36, Chapter 10, Paragraph 176A. My goal is to help you to understand why America is in distress. And hopefully you will do something to help get us out of this dire situation that we are in. For this program, I will be helping you by showing you part 3 of the video entitled Police State 2000. But before going into that, I would like to mention that I have talked with people here in Abbeville, Louisiana for 20 years, trying to get them to pay attention to things like the police state that's being formed here in America. And for some reason, people just don't have the interest. They don't care to pay attention to things like the police state that's being formed here in America. Well, here in Abbeville, Louisiana, we have what's called the Giant Omelet Celebration. And on the second day of November 2014, the celebration took place. And I wondered if there were any people there that cared to pay attention to the Giant Omelet. So I took my camera to the Giant Omelet Celebration, and this is what I found.
Yeah.
like they had a few people that cared to pay attention to the celebration concerning the giant omelet here in Abbeville, Louisiana. Why do you think they wouldn't want to pay attention to the police state that's being formed here in America? Could it be that they don't understand that as the police state rolls in, their rights rolls out? Well, if you're one of the ones that don't understand what a police state is all about, I am going to help you at this time by showing you part 3 of this video entitled Police State 2000, released by Alex Jones.
Delta Force did visit San Antonio later the next year during Operation Last Dance, held February 8th through February 20th. They also smashed into Kingsville, Port Aransas, Alice, Texas, Corpus Christi. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, and other towns. This is absolutely out of control. We're about to go through this story in sequential order. In some cases, especially in the case of Port Aransas, the local authorities were not even warned before massive military training, if you can call it that, was engaged in. Right here in America, it is clear psychological warfare against the police, the public, and everyone else in this nation, conditioning us to accept a militarized police state. It's basic terrorism, and I'm sad to say that about our military. But I forgot, it's Bill Clinton's military, isn't it? We can only imagine what's coming in the future with other administrations. This is an evil precedent that has been set. On the night of February 8th, 1999, right after my radio show, I got the word the Delta Force had smashed into the first of 6 towns, Kingsville, Texas. We got in the car, drove through the night to the South Texas coast, right in the middle of Texas oil country. It was incredibly surreal. Shades of Blade Runner. Boy, we can still smell the fire. You fixing this area where it burned through? Hey, how you doing? Alex Jones from Austin, Texas. I got a radio show and a little TV show. What's your name?
Jerry McQueen.
Jerry McQueen?
Yes, sir.
So you're fixing the fire damage here?
Yes, sir. Boarding up the windows and doors.
So you're boarding up the windows and doors?
Yes, sir.
From Army Special Operations Command's work?
Yes, sir. Securing it so that way no vandalism or anything.
You're securing it so no vandalism.
Well, they still tear things up.
So. Oh, I understand. No, we appreciate what you're doing. Just a few more questions if you have the time. I understand you're busy. Did you actually see Army Special Operations Delta Force?
I seen some of it. That was it.
What color were their uniforms?
I don't recall. It was dark and from a distance.
From a distance, you really couldn't make out their black uniforms very closely.
Yeah, it's kind of hard.
All different types of helicopters or just mainly one type?
Mainly one type that I'd seen.
Was that Black Hawk?
I'm not sure. I don't know.
Larger helicopters?
Medium size, I'd say.
Medium size. Were the police working with them in these exercises?
They had the streets blocked off.
Basically, this is a brick building, so the flammable things burned.
Yes. Just like wood and things like that, I guess.
So basically, this building is burnt out on the inside?
Yeah, basically.
Yeah.
So it's just the things that are charcoaled on the inside.
Did the military come around here afterwards and clean up all the shell casings and things?
I'm pretty sure they did.
Did you hear weapons fire?
Yes, we heard machine guns. Or we heard weapons.
You heard machine guns and explosions?
Yeah, there's explosions.
Could you see the explosions or just hear them?
You can just hear them.
Can you, I know...
I need to...
Oh, yes, sir.
Back to work here.
Yes, sir. Thanks for your time.
All right.
Keith, you go around inside while I keep it diverted, and I'll get us some of the fire damage footage.
Sure, give it a shot.
Well, you're looking at the upper floor, and our cameraman's a little bit nervous, as you can see. of the Kingsville Police Department's Detectives Building, supposedly deserted. We'll go downstairs in just a little while and show you the damage there, and then we'll go interview some folks around the town, from just average citizens to officials. Again, why are they practicing taking over police stations? In Kingsville, they did warn some of the officials. In Port Aransas, they did not. Again, we ought to just think about that for a second. Why are they engaging in this behavior? To condition the police as well as the general citizenry. Completely burnt out on the second floor of the Kingsville Police Department Detectives Building. Well, here we have it. Well, they've blown open the door and they're ransacking. They've come in and pulled out all the fire damage and put up new plywood over there, as you can see. That's where they came through the windows. Well, here we go through the murk, through the fire damage they've pulled out. Notice the workmen repainting the supposedly abandoned Kingsville Police Department. That doesn't make much sense to me, but again, who knows? Maybe I am a conspiracy theorist, but why was it still fully furnished with leather chairs and file cabinets and desks and computer screens and phone systems? You never know. I'm still trying to figure that out. Perhaps they wanted everything left intact so their training and their psychological test would be pulled off a little bit cleaner and smoother. Again, you decide.
See, y'all are just painting over the black burn marks?
Mm-hmm.
Delta Force Munitions, a solid ceramic slug used to blast open doors. So the jackbooted thugs don't even have to hurt their feet anymore. They just got these.
Juan Garcia.
Juan, what's your position here in the city of Kingsville?
Oh, I work for Malby Construction.
So y'all are just contracted out for the city to repair?
Secure the buildings. That's all. This building and the Exxon building. And that's it. I mean, that's our only job.
So now y'all are here just to secure and put the windows back in and kind of tear out some of the fire damage and things that were caused here to the police station.
Yeah, we were, we were waiting to seal off the building. So that's all they told us, you know. They told us we were going to be sealing off a building late at night, and that's all, you know. That's
after it was broken into.
Right.
Did you see what happened?
We heard gunfire and, small explosion and stuff, but actually what actually happened, though, the helicopters, you know, zooming around.
Can you tell us what you saw and heard?
Basically what I saw was just the helicopters flying around and gunfire and explosions, you know. But the police were all there, and they told us, don't be calm, you know. It's just an exercise.
Just be calm. And yeah. Were the police working with the military?
Yes, sir, they were, as far as I know. Because they sealed off the streets, you know, in pretty much in a hurry.
Have y'all fixed any bullet holes inside?
No, sir, we don't. We're not doing it. All we're doing is the exterior of the building, you know.
Was there bullet holes inside?
We saw some. And now that's, you know, you couldn't hear very much because there was a lot of noise, the choppers and stuff.
How many choppers?
I can't recall. I would say like six. I didn't count them. There were small ones and big ones, so.
Oh, small ones and big ones. We were told that there were actually some attack Apache-type aircraft and then also some Blackhawks in support that were actually actually delivering the troops.
Right, I guess. I mean, like I said, I don't know the difference between the helicopters, but There was several big ones and some small ones and stuff.
So you saw several big ones and some small ones. Can you try to give us a ballpark figure?
I would say five, six, somewhere on there. I don't remember.
So two or three small ones and two or three big ones?
Yeah, there wasn't very many big ones. I think there was only like two big ones, that's it. And then the rest were just small.
So two large helicopters and four small helicopters.
Right, just black.
Black helicopters.
Yes, sir.
And you couldn't see any markings. Were there lights on the helicopters?
No, sir, not when I saw them. Not at all.
And how low were they?
Oh, right above the buildings. You know, real low.
Real low.
Yeah.
And that's incredibly dangerous. What's your name?
Gracie.
Gracie?
Uh-huh.
Gracie, you live here in Kingsville?
Yes, sir. I live in that building right there in Casa Ricardo.
Wow, you live real close. Did you hear about the helicopter assault on the old police station before it happened?
No. Until that day. There were all these over there and right there. I'm sorry.
No.
And all that time, you know, all of the, there'd been, you know, surroundings like that.
And basically, were you at home when you heard the explosions?
Well, for a matter of fact, I had gone for a walk. And I sit, and then when I got here,
You were actually out here.
I sit on the bench, and then I got scared because, you know, because of the noise. It was so terrible and too loud, you know.
What'd you see? What'd you hear?
Well, there were throwing some bombs, you know, bombing.
Right.
Yeah. And some, I think they were using some rifles, too, and the other kind of rifles, you know, the one you know, stuff like that.
Ladies and gentlemen, Gracie lives in Casa Ricarda, approximately 250 feet from the Kingsville Detectives Building, the police department. Casa Ricarda is a nursing home, an old folks' home. This lady's out for a walk, and suddenly black helicopters, men in uniforms, running around firing automatic weapons. Now tell me that is not pure insanity and total disregard for the public's safety. Let's continue with the interview.
Just, you know, going back and forth and doing the same thing, you know, but I just couldn't see anything else because I was so scared. I went back to my apartment, and you know. And
so you were out walking, and you actually...
Well, I think it started when I got from my walk. I'm not really too sure.
What'd you see in here again?
Uh-huh.
You were saying...
I went back to my apartment because I was so scared, and I got out of from there because I could still hear the noise, you know. It was too loud
Make
and
the
too
noise
fast.
Just pow, 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 or...
Yeah, of everything, you know. I think they were doing everything on the same time.
Explosions and firing.
And everything on the same time. And then I saw one getting down from a parachute and way over there.
You're kidding.
Yes, I did.
What kind of uniforms were they in?
I couldn't barely tell.
You couldn't really see them in the dark.
Yeah, it was dark. So it was no way. Well, maybe it's, you know.
Black uniform?
Or green or something like that, you know. Like the ones that they have, the men from the National Garden. I think they're the same. I can barely tell, and I can barely tell if they were wearing, you know, something like that, like his, or I really couldn't tell. But
were
I
they,
saw one.
What about the helicopters?
Well, the helicopters, I don't know. I haven't seen them, you know, so close. They were so big, and, you know.
What
just flying. Well, they look like blacks. I couldn't barely tell. Maybe they were black. I don't know.
No flashing lights on them or anything.
I'm afraid they were between. It was 7 to 9 in the evening. 7 to 9, and it's also it was a fire. But I don't know where. I think it was in that building.
Right? They've already painted over it.
Yeah.
Wasn't it all black this morning?
Yeah, it's been all these days like that. I think they fixed it up. But I couldn't tell if it was, you know, right there or over there. So I guess...
Now, wait. You said you saw somebody with a parachute. Can you point the direction where you saw the guy in the parachute?
Well, let's see. Like, near the fence. Way over there.
Way a couple hundred yards over there.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Now, were they coming down from ropes or actual parachutes?
Well, I couldn't barely tell.
They were just coming out of the sky in the dark.
I couldn't tell if he was a parachute, if he was a rope. I just saw him, you know, getting down. That's all.
That is just absolutely incredible. How long did it last?
Oh, I don't know. You mean when they finish the end? I'm not sure. It's like I said, it was 7 to 9. That's what they told me there. I'm not sure.
And so it went on for several hours.
Yeah, I'm afraid so.
The gunfire and all the rest of it.
Yeah.
Well, they had trouble with their imaginary enemy, didn't they?
I guess.
Must have been many different teams.
They were using so many things that I could barely tell what they were.
So there were explosions and rapid gunfire?
Uh-huh. And they also stopped on the top of the building right there.
Which one?
That one right there, you know?
You're talking about the old Exxon building.
Yeah, that one right here.
They blew out almost every window in that building.
Yeah, that's what I.
We heard that large helicopters landed on the top.
Yes, mostly all of them. I think they stopped right there in that building on the top.
They just landed on top of the building.
Yeah, and then they got away. They flew away. And I also saw a lot of men, you know, that I think they were going up and those things, you know.
What about the police?
Well, the police, I don't know about them. I don't know what they did. They were just taking care of the area, that's all.
While the Delta Force did their work.
They were standing right there, and I went over there, and over here, there were a whole bunch of them. I think there were...
Did you appreciate not being warned and suddenly having black helicopters swarming?
No.
You didn't enjoy that?
No, not really, because, you know, I was thinking myself that they should be, you know, have done that here because it's dangerous, you know?
Well, you know what they're doing. They want to do this to citizens in the future, martial law, and I don't want to scare you as being prepared in this country. And what they're trying to do is, have you ever noticed how if you get somebody into something a little bit at a time, they're ready to accept it? They're easing America in to it to where people are used to seeing black helicopters fly over and explosions.
I don't know what to say about that.
Well, I'm not trying to scare you. They're not coming after you.
No, it's all right.
Don't worry, they're coming after
even
me.
Even if they are, maybe the others, they are. They said a war is coming this way, so I don't know. Maybe, you know, they just wanted us to know, to see how, you know, how they fight in the war. That's what I've been thinking about.
You're right. They want you to know that they're ready.
And maybe, you know, if that war comes over here, that war, you know, it probably would be another noise, you know, would be more louder and stronger, you know?
And again, your name one more time?
Gracie Longoria.
Gracie Longoria?
From here, from Kingsville.
Well, God bless you, and we appreciate taking
time. Well, God
time.
Bless you, too.
Right here in Kingsville, Texas, every window in the Exxon building has been smashed out. Every single window. And they've come in and boarded up every single one of them. This is from the explosions. They came and blew a hole in the roof, we're told. And the large helicopters landed here, again, at the Exxon administrative building that's been shut down for some time. Blew a hole in the roof and inserted troops inside and practiced killing the evil terrorist. And the police, again, were nearby helping as the relationship was growing. It's so much fun. Well, the entire front entrance that we're told was glass and metal by the lady across the street who will not speak on camera, from the Kingsville Publishing Company, the local newspaper, the Kingsville Record, says that yes, this was all metal-trimmed glass windows and the entrance right here were all blown away. Only Imperial stormtroopers are so precise. That's ridiculous. They blew out every window in the structure. Look at it. Must have been some powerful explosives. I'd like to see the inside of this building. And again, you got the newspaper right across the street, won't even talk to us. About the reporter that allegedly had his camera stolen.
Judy Hayes,
Alex Jones, nice to meet you.
What you've just seen is part 3 of the video entitled Police State 2000. Please watch for part 4 in a future program. And I hope you were with me at the beginning of this program whenever I talked about a giant omelet celebration that is held here in Abbeville, Louisiana. I failed at that time to mention that there were 5,030 eggs being cooked there. They started off with 5,000, and every year they add an egg. This is the 30th anniversary of the giant omelet celebration. So now they have 5,030 eggs being cooked. That's a lot of eggs. I wonder if there were any eggheads there. Think about that until next time. And until next time, may all your sunsets set right. And may the good Lord bless you both, day and night.
And you're playing on the wrong side, but you haven't got a pressure on me.